morning, everyone, and welcome to On the Couch with Rosanna Baptist Church on this very special Sunday. Hi, I'm Phil Sporton, and as always, I'm here with our senior pastor, David Buesnel. Good morning, David.
Good morning, Phil. How are you going?
Very well, indeed.
Good. Well, so we should be. This is a wonderful, wonderful morning that we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. And I have a sense that this is probably the greatest moment of our faith journey, the resurrection of Jesus. I was doing some research during the week, and I discovered that the root word for resurrection means to stand up. So imagine, here's Jesus. He's been laid to rest, dead, laid to rest in the tomb, and then suddenly he stands up and he walks out of the tomb fully alive. Amazing, amazing stuff. So, Philip, I want to ask you a question. What is the significance to you that Jesus walked out of the tomb, the place of death?
Well, for me, it changes everything. If Jesus walked from the tomb, his promise is through him, we can do likewise. Jesus takes us from no hope to hope. How does the old saying go? If you have no belief in the afterlife, it's eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow we die.
That's it.
Jesus takes us from being lifetime thinkers to be eternity thinkers, and that changes your whole lens on life.
Yeah, excellent. Excellent. Let's hear about it in our reading today, one of the wonderful readings about the resurrection morning. So over to you, Phil, to bring us the reading.
Okay, off to the reading.
Today's reading comes from the book of Mark, chapter 16, verses 1 to 8, and is headlined, Jesus Has Risen. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb and asked each other, who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb? But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. Don't be alarmed, he said. You are looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him? But go, tell his disciples and Peter, he is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you. Trembling and bewildered, the women went out and fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid.
Thanks, Phil. One of the number of readings about this wonderful resurrection morning and the women coming down filled with grief, fully anticipating to see a dead Jesus and anoint him for his burial. But they get there and it's not what they expected. The tomb is empty. And he is risen from the dead. Amazing stuff when you think about it. He is risen from the dead. Now, I've been thinking about this during the week. A lot of people don't believe in the resurrection. They say it's a lot of piffle, a lot of poppycock. Well, they can believe that if they want to. But the resurrection is God's proclamation, not my proclamation, not yours or not the church's, but it is God's own proclamation that Jesus is alive and present with us. You know, when Jesus was born, Phil, there was a little, the angel said that you will call his name Jesus because he will be God with us, Emmanuel. And you think about that. He came as a baby and it was declared that he was Emmanuel, God with us in human form. But from this moment on, he becomes Emmanuel, God with us in supernatural form, ready to work on our behalf and lives forever, as you've rightly said. It changes things from this life to the eternal life. So it's God's proclamation that Jesus is alive and present with us. It also reveals that death has been conquered. I think you've said that in your earlier answer to the question. No longer does death have the last laugh. You reckon, Phil?
Absolutely.
Death can't laugh at us anymore because Paul says death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory, says Paul. Where, O death, is your sting? There is no sting in death anymore. There is no victory in death, because death has been conquered and swallowed up in the victory of Christ when he rose from the dead. This is all God's work on our behalf, and it's amazing stuff he's done for us. Does it excite you, Phil, that Jesus is alive?
Absolutely. For without him, what is there to hope for? 80 years, 90, maybe 100 if you're lucky. We've got not one life in front of us. We've got a million lives, a million, million lives.
Yeah, we've eternal. I don't know who can define eternal for us, eternity. I don't think anybody can. It's just that concept that we will survive and move on forever in a different place, different circumstance, different situations. The other thing that came to me as I was thinking about this is that Jesus' resurrection affirms the value of the human person and the world in which we live. Jesus, he became one of us. And he came to show us what God was like. And rather than deny the physical, he embraced the physical. He retained his humanity. When he was raised from the dead, he could be touched. He could feel. He wasn't a spirit. He wasn't a phantom or a ghost. He was still human, maybe looking a bit different, but he was still a human being. He retained his humanity. And in doing that, he embraced the human condition. And so I think one of the great things about all this is that now we have a God who embraces our human condition and knows that we will die, because that's the condition. But the resurrection, as I think as Paul says, is a foretaste or a pointer to our own resurrection for those who die in Christ Jesus. I think that's fantastic. And finally, can I just say that the resurrection of Jesus from the dead is not the end of us. Isn't that great news, Phil?
Absolutely.
And this is the good news that we are meant to be sharing in our world, in a world that's so negative and so, you know, depressed and so full of death and hate. We have the message. He's alive. Jesus is alive. He's risen from the dead, and he brings life to all who trust and believe in him. And that's my message for today, for any of our hearers. If you do not have faith in God through Jesus, then as the resurrection, can I suggest that you explore that and receive this new life that comes through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Saviour. Amen.
Amen. Shall we close in prayer?
Let's do that, Phil. Christ is risen.
Amen.
He is risen indeed. Risen Lord Jesus Christ, we repeat our Easter shouts of surprise and joy again and again. For news of your victory over powers of death and evil is news so startling, so amazing, so different from the news that bombards us day by day. Beyond our comprehension, you startle us, Lord, again and again with resurrection life, bringing grace and hope and joy. You, our Lord, in your risen power, are shaping all our days. And so we praise you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Well, thank you, David, and thank you, everyone, for joining us on the couch on this special Sunday. If you've enjoyed this episode, can I ask you, please, do a bit to help others find Jesus Christ. Can you share this on your Facebook page? It's only a small thing to do, just to share it, and you never know. Thanks again, and thank you, David.
That's all right, mate. Hope everybody has a blessed Easter.
Amen.
And remember, he is risen. Bless you, everybody.
Only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I would do is forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, one will my your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only